The market is saturated with so many Mac apps, it can be hard to know which ones to download and which ones to skip. That's why for the last few years, I've been putting together a shortlist of free macOS app recommendations. And wouldn't you know, it's that time of the year again. Hey friends, I'm Tasia and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. In this video, I'm sharing the best Mac apps of 2021. These are the macOS apps every user needs. Come on, let's go. So first, Mr. Lobster and I will start with a few photo, audio, and video apps for Mac, and then we'll move into some Mac functionality apps and so on from there. So if you guys want to use the chapters below in this video to skip to anything specific, go ahead and do that. But be sure to stick around to the end for an extra special bonus Mac app edition, because it's just so fun. And as we go through these, if you're wondering why maybe some of your favorite macOS apps haven't made my list, it's quite possible I've covered them before in some of my other free macOS app recommendation videos, which are linked in the description below, and I'll link to them again at the end of this video. I try not to be too repetitive. So first up is Apollo 1. This is an image viewer that is way more robust than Preview. Right off the bat, you're able to rotate your images without having to save them to that specific orientation. But better yet is all the metadata that's available on the right-hand side here. Now, the interesting thing about this app is that it's compatible with a ton of raw image formats, and depending on your raw file, you can click on the photo and it's gonna use the metadata to tell you where the autofocus is in your image so you can know if it's accurate or not. Apollo 1 is also compatible with Lightroom. So you can use these built-in star rating systems here, which will actually transfer over to Lightroom if you open this image up in there. But it also has macOS tagging too. So you'll have these familiar color tags, but if you dig around a little further and back on your right-hand panel and click the note icon, and you can actually add a ton of other data to the image. So you can add location data and keywords in order for this to be easily searchable in your Spotlight on macOS. So handy. And Apollo 1 also has some histogram toggles here too, which can also be really handy when you're editing photos. So now let's move on to a great audio recording app, Paizo. Or maybe it's Piezo. Either way, this app is way easier to use than it is to pronounce. Paizo allows you to easily record audio on your Mac. You can record from any application or from any of your microphone inputs. So you just select your audio source and hit the record button. And you do also have a settings gear here too to export into your desired file formats. Just a simple little audio recording app. All right, we're gonna move on to the world of Wondershare. I'm a big fan of theirs and they have a lot of free apps you'll wanna take advantage of. But for this video, let's talk about Wondershare Filmora. I actually can't believe I haven't told you guys about this app yet. Wondershare Filmora is, at its core, a video editing app. It's got some really cool effects, elements, and transitions built into the app. And yes, while you'll need to pay to access some of these cool features, there's a lot available with the free download. So for example, do you know what I use Wondershare Filmora for? Go on, take a guess. Okay, forget it, you'll never be able to guess. I actually use this app to capture high-res PNGs from video files. So when I'm shooting a YouTube video like this, meta, I actually take footage of what I think my thumbnail is going to be, and then I pull that clip into Filmora. Then I use this camera icon right here to grab a high-resolution snapshot of that frame of the video. Can you believe that's how to take high resolution photos from a video? And speaking of high resolution photos, go ahead and give this video a like if you're finding it valuable. Wait, what? Okay, you caught me. This really has nothing to do with high resolution pictures from videos, but if you give this like a video, it really does help signal YouTube to tell you that this is indeed the content you were looking for. Now, back to that content. As promised, let's move into some Mac functionality apps. First up is Rectangle, an easy way to move and resize macOS windows using keyboard shortcuts. Rectangle is a huge time saver because you can use either these built-in keyboard shortcuts or you can actually create your own keyboard shortcuts to move and resize your windows in macOS. But it would be a pain to have to remember keyboard shortcuts all the time, right? Well, you don't have to. In the top menu bar, you can just click on the little rectangle icon, and voila, you have all the snap options you could ever dream of just a click away. And by the way, many people may recommend the Magnet app to do this on macOS, but guess what? The Magnet app is not free, and as the title of this video would suggest, Rectangle is a completely free app. It literally does the exact same thing as Magnet, but for free.
You're welcome.
So now let's move on to a weather app. And you're probably like, really, a weather app for my Mac? Please. But just hear me out. So I'm not the biggest fan of the native iOS weather app or the weather widget that's found in your notification center on macOS. So here's what I mean. If you click on the date in your menu bar, your notification center pops out from the right, and in it, you can get a quick snapshot of the weather, but I just don't really think this is very robust. Enter the WeatherDock app. With WeatherDock installed and kept in your dock, you'll have a quick snapshot of the weather right there whenever the app is open. And speaking of when the app is open, you get a handy snapshot of the current weather, upcoming weather for this day, as well as a 3-day forecast. Now, if you want to splurge and get the full version for $3, that will get you a 7-day ad-free forecast, but truthfully, this free version is fabulous. Okay, it wouldn't be a classic Tasia video without a bonus app for you. This is for all my Apple geeks, Mac lovers, computer nerds, and history buffs. The bonus app for today is Mac Tracker. Essentially, it's a reference tool app. But Tasia, what does it reference? Oh, are you ready for this? Mac Tracker gives you detailed information on every single Apple product that was ever made. So take a look at this. Not only does Mac Tracker give you crazy detailed info on literally any Apple device, like, okay, let's pick iBook for example. And look at this. We get this little image of what the device looks like, and we can learn when it was introduced, when it was discontinued, the price, weight, processor speeds, and just so much more. There's so many little detailed sections here that we can even learn more about the history of each device. Look, we can even learn what the tagline was when that device was released. I am truly gagged, but wait, there's more. You can actually track your personal Apple models with this app too, and the app will tell you if you're still in warranty or not. Truly, it's just so random, yet so epic. Again, remember, I'm linking to the 2018 through 2020 Mac app list below, and again at the end of this video. So be sure to check them out if you want to see even more macOS app recommendations. So those are my 2021 free macOS app recommendations. And now I want to hear from you. What are your favorite free Mac apps and why? Let everybody know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more macOS app videos. Come on, you know you wanna do it. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.